Brooklyn, a land with a myriad of sights, smells, and sounds. That last category being the most interest to us here at B-Side. And out of those many sounds, hitting our eardrums on a daily basis here in Brooklyn, pouring out of car stereos, blasting through apartment windows, and lighting up block parties all through this borough is hip hop. Kings County has given the world of hip hop legendary rappers like Big Daddy Kane, Mos Def, Jay-Z, Talib, Kweli, and Biggie Smalls, just to name a few. Joining those ranks is tonight's spectacular lyricist, the one and only Skyzoo. His latest album, Music for My Friends, is a collection of personal stories about himself, his friends, and activities and emotions they experienced during their formative teen years that shaped their adulthood. He's earned a solid reputation as a writer's writer when it comes to crafting his lyrics, and we're extremely fortunate to have him with us here tonight. One of Brooklyn's true hip-hop gems, the incredible Skyzoo. I'm your host, Ro Johnson, and coming up, an hour of music and conversation. Most definitely keep it locked here on B-Side.
To everybody listening to this, I appreciate it. This project is a story about me and my friends. Hopefully, the more you keep listening to it, the more you'll understand us. If you don't, that's cool. We'll be all right. But if you do, thanks. This is music for my friends. Enjoy.
Tell a couple stories for the night. It look a little bit like that. All day, always, all of us is for it, ain't a song change. And all that we done saw is what we all became. We all that we got long as the song played. We hung out in front of the corner store. Got all the rent, took it to the liquor store. Ha! Money low, so Bill, we wanted more. Only way we'll separate us, how we pick the course. Of course, we know where we belong. We know we're next to home, but won't be long until we home. See, know that when we home, we putting all where they can all see. Know that they'll adore how we adorn. So as long as we loaded up with cargo, whichever way the car go, the outcome's a mercy, a largo. Mercy upon anyone, feeling mercy at their heart, though. My outcome's a merciless God flow. God be with us, our army misses enough to inspire us. We days low for that loaf if they comfortable trying to see. Baby, it's easy to adapt to what you be around. Being next to A is why my aim will never see the ground. Being next to bro is why you know we all or nothing, right? Being next to Mel, we never fell, we never cut the lights. Being next to Pesos with GQ and Bishop before they hiccups. Loyalty is nothing you could pay for. Love him like a brother, that man there like my brother. And if it should ever come that that man would let a K go. Going for advancement is the route we were standing. Scared of being dormant, so we grew with our hands in. Hands put together all the prayers people sent us saying, don't believe the hype, don't grow up. And be a, don't grow up and become a typical. While you here like who you were every day, lead them over there. What? Damn, I feel funny even saying that. That word is foreign and my friends can never make me that. So, duly know that if needed, but no, it never will. Easy to adapt if you're around whatever's real. So all day, always, all of us is for it. Ain't a song change. And all that we done saw is what we all became. We all that we got long as the song plays. All day, always, all of us is for it, ain't a song change. All that we done saw is what we all became. We all that we got long as the song plays. All day, always, all of us is for it, ain't a song change. All that we done saw is what we all became. And we all that we got long as the song plays.
Welcome. So happy to have you here.
Thank you.
You're definitely known as a lyricist. So I just wanted to talk to you first about your lyrical abilities and the fact that it sometimes it seems like it's a lost art. in hip hop right now.
Right.
And how do you feel about that? Do you agree with me?
Yeah, I do. You know, but I think the good thing about it, though, at the same time, even though it seems lost, is that it's starting to come back around. You know, there's a lot of artists that are getting play on the radio that do have that ability, that do put that forth. You know, there's a handful of people we can name. So even though it may not be all day on the radio, you know, it may not be the 40 songs that you hear 40 times a day, you may get 5 or 10 that you hear over and over all day, and those guys do come from that same cloth. So it's starting to come back. You see it, you know, the tide is starting to change and all that.
So who would you put in that category? Right now, like the top 40, the 40 times you hear it a million times.
Right. The guys that's on the radio that are doing it, I mean, obviously, you know, J. Cole, Kendrick, you know, Drake, and sometimes people like to give, you know, they feel a way about Drake, or they do or they don't, but, you know, Drake is definitely lyrical, so, you know, you put him there. There's a good handful of people that have the capability that do it when they have the time to, as far as the setting and what they're doing musically and where it makes sense. There's a handful of guys.
Okay. But usually, do you feel like you don't really hear that lyricism on the radio? It's usually kind of on the album.
Right, absolutely. A couple guys do it, you know, on the radio as well. But for the most part, yeah, you might have to dig a little bit.
Okay, I got you. Now, I heard that you go into the studio and you just go off the dome. You don't pre-write any of your lyrics, you know, kind of like how Biggie did it.
Right, well, I do write, but I don't write at home ahead of time. I write everything on the spot. So I don't go off the head when it comes to the studio. You know, I'll go off the head on the radio or whatever. When it comes to the studio, I write everything, but it's just not ahead of time. So what I do is I go to the studio, hit a beat, pull out the phone, and just start writing. So it's nothing that's premeditated. It's nothing where I sat home for 2 days writing and then took it to the studio. And that's not knocking anybody's formula who does that. But it's just whatever works per artist, per creative mind. You know, it's whatever makes sense for that person. And for me, the inspiration really comes when I'm at the studio, sitting in front of the monitor, speaker, lights low, phone in my hand, and the beat is just blaring and it's beating a hole in my ears, and then I'm just writing, and 20 minutes later I'm done and I just record. So that's the process.
Okay, cool. Well, I want to hear another one of the songs off your album coming up next, but I wanted to ask you, do you feel like that's a lost art in hip hop, just being able to just to freestyle and just come up with things?
Oh, absolutely. Right? Absolutely. You know, a lot of times you'll hear about guys who go on the radio, or, you know, you'll see the word freestyle next to their name for whatever it is, and it's something that's pre-written or whatever. And that's definitely a lost art, for sure. Even a lot of the guys who may be lyrical and may come with it, the off-the-dome, you know, aesthetic is definitely lost. But I pride myself on being able to do that as well.
All right, cool. Well, what are you going to play next for us?
Speaking of lyricism, I want to get into a record called Suicide Doors, which is a barrage of lyricism.
I got some questions for you about that.
Let's
one
do
afterwards.
It. Let's do
so,
it.
Yeah, I want to hear it.
Absolutely.
All right.
As I think of how to begin this, I already thought of the ending. And if the ending didn't taste the way the start of a sprinting, then I'm really rewinding what isn't. Get it? Swear it gets harder to get it, but when you got it, to get it again's more innocent. It's like product concealing the end is in the sense. Our lights got us, sealing the winds where it begins. It's right by us, labeled it tight bias. To be one and the same, or maybe they might buy us. And see one of us change, or say that they might buy us. And leave us yet again for a gain, like pills on the banners of your screen. Know the handle of the regime is the handle on the lead. The hands do extend till the hand is out of reach. The reach be the limbs that'll balance out the means. The means to it all to get a ski mask involved. And you winning or you swimming in the flood of the maroon type. Sheets by the dozen and you covered by a boom mic. Pardon, the most humble of an autograph. The threaded needles of desert eagles and honest raps. The high thinking you can find more. The balance of the script when the shooter signs off. Ballerina fits like 2 inside 4. All for the intrigue of a suicide door. One time, we saw the doors lifting up. And then they never came down. I mean, they rode around the block with the doors lifted up, like they was flying off the ground. And then they told us that they call those suicide doors. They said they call those suicide doors. The brake lights was $100 Bill Green. Yeah. It's green for a suicide door. as we take this to a further route. The steps move like it's word of mouth. The steps move like if they were stepping with us when we further out. So step two becomes the workaround. It gets lighter than a fly knit, tighter than an eye slit, brighter than the writer you was bright enough to climb with. Complimenting you while big enough me, it just bring us up to speed to the steps that we align with. Then it all ties in, tied up to keep down. I'll cover up your eyes when it flies like you D. Brown. The complexities are rubbing arms next to me. It all adds to these bags of longevity. It's like I'm Wayne Shorter with a ratchet fetish, or I'm in DC's with a jazz collection. In other words, I cover what they cover like overflowing cupboards spilling gold medal dreams. And running through the cupboard like you gold medal breed or bread and fed how that gold medal steams. Meaning's all over, you could pick the one that suits you. Depending on the tie, the accessories could lose you. You see how we still twisting this together? Black ice dangled from the mirror that reflect us. Black ice tangled till a loop is tied off. And all the intrigue of a suicide door. One time, we saw the doors lifting up. And then they never came down. I mean, they rode around a block with the doors lifted up. Like they was flying off the ground. And then they told us that they call those suicide doors. They said they call those suicide doors. The brake lights was $100 bill green. And we was green for a suicide door. Talk to them. Yeah, one time, we saw the doors lifting up, and then they never came down. I mean, they rode around the block with the doors lifted up, like they was flying off the ground one time.
All right, so that's one of my favorite cuts. That's one of my favorite cuts on your album, your latest album, because you go deep. You go way back. We'll talk about that in a minute. But,
absolutely.
I like the storytelling that you have, and it just seems like there's a lot of, you know, you're going back and forth about the temptations and the you know, choices that you guys made as kids. But is there a part of you that's talking to kids today, kind of warning them against some of those things, or kind of warning them against that material, that glorification of materialism?
It's definitely me speaking to, you know, kids nowadays, just because I understand what it is. So whether it's looked at as a warning or whether it's looked at as someone who relates, it's definitely me speaking to them nowadays as someone who gets it. You know, I think a lot of times, as opposed to being spoken down to, it's easier to be level, eye level, and just kick it, you know. So it's definitely a lot of that. You kind of hit the nail on the head.
All right. Well, in researching and learning more about you, and I've talked to you before, so I know that you've gone to some great schools, and you've gotten probably like one of the best educations New York City public schools has to offer.
You heard that, Mom? If my mother's
and
watching.
On top of that, you had, you know, your mom and dad both in your life. You even said, you know, that your mom was always there, and your mom was there for every scene. I can't remember the
lyrics. Right.
I know you talked about that.
Right.
So you had some incredible role models. Do you feel like you're trying to, and then you always, in some of your previous mixtapes, you've kind of idealized like the Huxtables as like the perfect situation or the perfect setting. Are you trying to provide that for some of the kids too?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I think with nowadays, it's a lot of what we see. Mm-hmm. And everything is in your phone, everything is in your hand, everything is what's right in front of you. And I think that, you know, nowadays, you have to be able to see beyond all that. And if whatever's in your phone in your hand is what you see, then maybe we can switch that up a little bit and you can see this, but then you can also see that and see what it all is.
Okay.
And, you know, I think, yeah, again, you hit the nail on the head. I think that's, I mean, you know,
you're painting a different picture.
Yeah, absolutely.
And if you can see something, then you can aspire to it.
Right.
You know, all right, cool. So we've been very rude because we didn't introduce your crew,
people.
So let's meet. Who do you have here with you today?
Oh, this is my DJ Prince.
Okay.
One time for DJ Prince.
Hey, what's up? How are you?
Right. And this is my trumpet player, Sean Taylor.
All right, cool. Well, I've definitely noticed all the instrumentation and the jazz influences on your album. So I just want to know a little bit about your production process. And you've worked with some incredible, like, producers over the years.
Right, thank you.
So, like, what's the criteria that you go through to picking producers or tracks or
right.
whatever?
For me, it's what makes sense, you know? It's whatever makes sense. Whether the producer has done everything on the radio or is working a 9-to-5 and then going home to work on his craft later, you know, it doesn't matter to me. The name doesn't matter. It's all about the sound and what works. And, you know, my abilities and my talents and everything I've been blessed to be able to do is what's walked me in certain rooms to work with certain people, you know? So the same way I can work with a young kid who's up and coming, I could work with some of the biggest producers in the world because of what I've been able to do, the work I've put in, the material that I've put out, and it's a blessing, you know? So when I go looking for beats and I pick beats, it's really about telling the story. And for me, I just want to tell stories. I just want to tell great stories. And when I write, it's weird, I want the beat to kind of start telling the story for me ahead of time. So when I hear a beat, I kind of want to feel like the beat is already telling me what to do. I just got to do it. It's like the beat is saying, yo, this is what we're going to talk about. Just fill in the blanks. So then when I go, I just fill in the blanks, you know?
Okay, so tell me about the process, that production process with this album, with Music For My Friends. How did that?
Yeah, it's just a further extension. You know, for me, every project is about growth, elevation, constantly just doing more and more. And, you know, for this project, it was more of the jazz aesthetic that I'm a big fan of, but I've never tried to overdo it with the jazz. I never wanted to be the guy who just bombarded you with jazz and you thought that when you came to a Skyzoo show, we was snapping fingers. You know, that was never gonna be the MO, you know? I'm still from 15 minutes from here. I'm still from down the block, in a sense. So, you know, it was never gonna be that. I just wanted to be able to incorporate certain things and merge them together, you know, as far as the world I know, dirty drums and hard-hitting beats, but bring in the trumpet, bring in Fender Rhodes, and bring in string sections and saxophones and all those different elements, and then make it make sense somehow.
Well, for me, it was very reminiscent of Jazzmatazz with Guru.
Okay.
That
word
I loved that. I used
classic,
to run
classic,
that album.
Absolutely.
So, yeah, that's
yeah.
What it was very reminiscent of.
Absolutely.
That. So on that note, let me hear some more.
Let's go into, I got a record called Everything's For Sale.
Okay.
That I would like to jump into and let's
cool.
Let's walk right into that.
Ready, Sean?
All good. We can run it. Brooklyn's out here heavy for us tonight. Everything's for sale. Yeah, everything's for sale. 5 passports, we never going to jail. Hey, they said everything's for sale. 5 passports, we never going to jail. Okay. We do it like this. Outside still smelling like where the winners at. Look at all these empires under these fitted hats. Look at the grills on the cars we could be leaning on. Now look at all these unmarked cars that's reeling back. How real is that? Hey, how real it is? All of us is just pictures of what the city did. The city made us to keep it the way you see it though. Or be alone if the world say what the city is. And we is who we say we is, you know us well. Part nerd, part grind like I know Pharrell. Frenzies outside, don't ever slow the deal. No circulars here, you can't hold a sale. For real, low sweats and aqua eights. Blew through the caution as long as you got a plate. Fruits of the labor, whoever should want to taste. I swear we heard that all, yo, everything they would say. All of it though, they said everything's for sale. Told us 5 passports and we never going to jail. So we working on the second and the third and the fourth and the fifth. Till it clicks like everything is for real, for real. They said everything's for sale. Told us 5 passports and we never going to jail. So we working on the second and the third and the fourth and the fifth. Till it clicks like everything is for real. 6 degrees from whoever you need to get you yours. And try and get it. It is everything they applaud. Applause come by the doubles and double laws. The rhythm of it is trusting in the facade of an 80,000 genie, put us fly to Lashante. Tint it up, me and mine hiding like a wand, yeah. Role players rather stand around till your part change. Out for your cast, everybody on their Andre, right? We the products of seeing product and comprehended. You see a bottle, you see a motto, you compliment it. Early morning on that morning, throwing hard blocks, calling Zoe season, trying to make a couple cards pop. Pop, like if you sitting in your living room and you can hear pop on the daily till it's typical. And tying up the motive like my double entendres until my friends could tell you that I LeBron them. Cause all of them, they said everything's for sale. So it's 5 passports and we never going to jail. So we working on the second and the third and the fourth and the fifth till it clicks like everything is for real. For real, he said everything's for sale. Told us 5 passports and we never going to jail. So we working on the second and the third and the fourth and the fifth till it clicks like everything is for real. Everything is for sale. Sean on a hump it and all of that is for real. For real. He said everything is for sale. Sean on the trumpet and all of that is for real. For real. Talk to him something.
Heavy things to sell. Five passports, we never going to jail. We're working on a second and third and fourth and fifth. So it's click like everything is for bread. Everything is for sale. Told us five passports and we never going to jail. Working on the second and third and fourth and fifth. So it's click like everything is for bread.
Thank you.
All right, so I've mentioned this before. You've been in the game for a long time.
Right.
And then you had a project. Your debut project was in 06, right?
Yeah.
Cloud Nine.
EP, yep.
3 Day High?
Yep.
Okay. So how have you evolved? Because you've had, what is it, like 3 studio albums and like over 17 mixtapes?
Yeah,
something like that?
When you think about it,
it's crazy.
You have a lot of rap. A lot of music.
It's 3
studio albums. Three EPs and a plethora of mixtapes. So yeah, about 16, 17 joints.
How have you changed and evolved since, you know, over the span of your career so far?
Right. For me, again, it goes back to the elevation idea that I brought up earlier. What I do, I'm a huge basketball fan, huge sports fan, so I relate everything to basketball. So for me, making music is like shooting jumpers. And, you know, you hear the stories of Ray Allen shooting 1,000 jumpers a day, which is why he's one of the greatest shooters ever. You know, so for me, whatever you do, do it every day. Do it to where you continue to get better and better every day. So for me with music, I shoot 1,000 jumpers a day musically, you know. So I may not write and record every day because I don't, you know, I only write and record when I have a project on deck. But I freestyle every day. When I'm in the crib, I freestyle, cleaning the crib, doing dishes, whatever. Like, you know, it's weird, but like I freestyle every day in the crib. So that's lyrical exercise for me. That's shooting 1,000 jumpers a day. And that's how each project is able to enhance and grow. And however the fans feel about me on a certain project, it's always however many levels up on the next one, because if it's not, then they could have left me alone on the last one. So I'm never gonna be the guy who, yo, this album is cool, the last one or the one before that was the one. That's never gonna happen, because for me, it's always about the jumper being wetter. You know, it's all about every day, just 1,000 joints.
Okay, so that kind of gets to my next question, which is, of all your releases and albums, which one is your favorite?
Oh, Music for My Friends.
Okay.
Music for My Friends.
And
because
why?
The only reason why is because, you know, besides the elevation I brought up, just where I went musically, you know, every project I have creative freedom. And it's something that I'm very blessed and humbled to be able to say, because a lot of artists, a lot of my peers, a lot of artists who I know personally, who have done tons of things, don't have the liberty to say that, you know, and it sucks, you know, but I'm able to move how I want to move musically. So with this album, it's just a further extension of what I wanted to do musically. So everything I envisioned for this project, everything I saw for this album, it went exactly the way I wanted it to, whether it was the trumpet stuff with Sean, whether it was everything Prince brought to the table, whether it was, you know, the keys and different musical elements, whether it was the stories I wanted to tell, just everything panned out. All these ideas and I want this to sound like this. I want that to sound like that. I got an idea for a record to do this, and then it transitions into that. It all came together seamlessly. So this one for sure.
Do you feel like putting, this is your first release on your own label. Do you feel like that kind of gave you that creative license to go do whatever you wanted and you didn't have to answer to anybody?
Yeah. I mean, I always was able to do what I wanted musically, but this was even more freedom. You know, this was able to really just move around and say, hey, I'm taking the reins solo dolo. And of course, that brings more pressure, that brings more responsibility, that brings all these different elements that people at home may or may not know. But at the same time, it's totally worth it. It's worth everything that comes with it.
So now I'm gonna put you on the spot, because you said you freestyle every day, like you're washing dishes, whatever. So I want a beat, this is not on the playlist, it's not on the set list.
Right. We don't need a beat. She want me to freestyle.
Yeah.
She want me to freestyle that I walk into that.
Yes.
Room full of fans that I walk into rap. It's off of the top, like if I was off with the hat, still be freestyling. See how I'm talking to that? The flow is conversational. I talk when I rap. I give you words, you give them back. It's all for the raps, all for the fans, it's all for the people and how we moving. And hopefully they get it and they stick within the movement, within it, and it's all there seamless. I'm on the B-side screen. You see this?
Woo! I love it, I love it, I love it.
Freestyle.
Yeah. All right, yeah. So we're gonna move on into your next song.
Yes.
All right, and then let's I got some more questions for you afterwards.
Let's do it.
What song is this coming up?
Woman.
Prince, whatever Prince wants to play. We freestyle the sets too.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
Whatever Prince plays.
Yeah, let's do that. The moment joint.
Let's do.
The woman.
Yeah.
Let's
do I that. Thought I heard you say
what?
That.
Yeah, let's do
what
that.
Do you
let's
say?
Do that. Let's do that joint.
You gonna see? Oh. We freestyling the set.
Okay.
Yeah.
Models is a given, know that off the luck. But all we want is just some women who could cook. Said all we want is just some women who could cook, right? Said all we want is just some women who could cook. Walking around the kitchen and your Vickies get us hooked. Yeah. Cause all we want is just some women who could cook, right? Said all we want is just some women who could cook, right? Said all we want is just some women who could cook, yeah. In the kitchen stove clicking while you looking back. I'm looking too, I look at you like let me cook a nap. I'm walking through while you working to put your foot in that. I bust a move and serve you like where Brooklyn at. Right here, baby, I'm right here, baby. And your hand touching your stomach like you right there, baby. Believe it, sucker for curves and knowing no way to keep a curve. So you swiffing up a plate is like the sweetest words. Sing a couple tunes, the aroma hit the room. Like if you was K. Michelle, I you berserking with a spoon. Baby crazy at the stovetop, oven door, dope spot. Snatching up a crown, how you cut them all, clothes shop. Late night, early morning, sweet boba benefits. You could pull shrimp and grits, I'll be at your fingertips. Talking with your hands and have me listening for days. And tell your friends that all of my friends feel the same. Because models is a given, know that off the look. Cause all we want is just some women who could cook, right? Said all we want is just some women who could cook, right? Said all we want is just some women who could cook. Hey, walking around the kitchen and your Vickies get us hooked. Cause all we want is just some women who could cook. Hey, said all we want is just some women who could cook, right? Said all we want is just some women who could cook. Yeah. From the cave, but my family from the country. A bowl of banana pudding is the dopest way to love me. Say I get you the dopeness. I say I'm just whipping the way you whip at the stove. Compliments and doses. Compliment the way that you was brought up by your mother. Like, baby, I never met her, but I love her. Tell her I love her. Tell her you now how addicted we can both get. You strung off the long and me up the salmon crochets. You be on your chop, go a million off whatever. You had the Planet Fitness and you shave it off your measurements. Calling a sweet potato powder where you let me in. Even though I can't fit at all, ain't a better fit. Double meaning still around, double up throughout the day. Double season in your style, baby. Talking with your hands and have me switching up your name. And tell your friends that all of my friends feel the same. Because models is a given, know that off the luck. But all we want is just some women who could cook. Said all we want is just some women who could cook, right? Said all we want is just some women who could cook, right? Walking around the kitchen and your Vickies get us hooked. Because all we want is just some women who could cook. Said all we want is just some women who could cook. Right, said all we want is just some women who could cook. Know that with the luck. All we want is just some women who could cook. Said all we want is just some women who could cook. Right, all we want is just some women who could cook. Hey, walk around the kitchen and your Vickies get us hugged. All we want is just some women who could cook. All we want is just some women who could cook. Right, all we want is just some women who could cook. Yes.
Tracks on the album too.
Mine too.
So
thank you.
It's funny because you're like, you don't want models anymore. You're growing up.
Well, we do.
You do still want models, but you want models that can cook.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So we're just saying it got to be a little more than just that.
Just
it got to be more than just a scroll right. On the gram.
You got to have, you know, something.
You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, you scroll on the gram, yo, she's bad,
upstairs.
She's bad.
Okay.
But, a lot of loaves of bread in the house, you know what I'm saying, make the sandwiches. I could do that.
Well, I mean, that speaks to the whole theme of the album, too. And,
yes.
And you've talked in other interviews about, you know, kind of how this album is not for the industry. It's just for your friends.
Right.
And so is it anti-industry?
No,
is it
no.
Pushback against the industry?
No, okay. Not in the slightest. It really just meant the things that I'm speaking on are things that my friends more than anyone can relate to, mm-hmm. more so than ever before. You take The Salvation, you take A Dream Deferred, you take all the other mixtapes and different things I've done in between. You can relate to those things, and my friends relate to them for sure, but this one, my friends were calling me when the album came out, and they were mm-hmm. like, yo, this is nuts. Because, yo, you spoke about when we was da-da-da-da-da, and when so-and-so had the thing in the locker, and so-and-so did this, and so-and-so did that, and, you know, and they loved it. They loved that it was them in the, even the cover, you know, even the cover art. Those are my real friends on the cover. So when I showed my friends the cover, they was like, oh, that's crazy, that's crazy. But I showed them on the phone and a text. Mm-hmm. And then when it came out, they were calling me like, yo, you really put this out? I'm like, yeah, stupid, I told you I was putting it out. Like, you know what I mean? Like, they was like, yo, that's crazy. You put me in Best Buy, you put me on iTunes. So, you know, it's a beautiful thing.
Okay, so which friend is which in on the cover? So who's that?
Oh, man, so that's my man, bro. And then that's my man, A. Uh-huh. That's my man, Pesos, uh-huh. And that's me.
Any of them here today?
Nah.
But they're watching from home.
Absolutely.
Of course.
Well, my friends are, my friends aren't in the industry at all. Okay. They're, you know, more so into life, you know? So they're not industry, they don't know much about the industry, they don't know much about, you know, being in music, and they know what's on the radio, whether they like it or not, and then they know me.
Okay.
You know?
So I know that you talked, and we didn't really talk about this earlier, but you're from Clinton Hill, Bed-Stuy?
Yeah, it was called Bed-Stuy.
It was called
Bed-Stuy. Growing up in
Clinton Hill was a creation.
Right. They moved the line,
and then
South Jamaica? South Jamaica, Queens. Yeah, yeah. Shout out to South Jamaica one time. When I was in high school, I moved out to South Jamaica, Queens. And actually, my man A, who's on the cover, that's my best friend in the world, and we met out there. Okay. You know what I mean? So the cover's like a merge of all of my friends, different walks of life and things that I kind of merged together for the cover to paint the scene. But my man A, I actually met out in South Jamaica, and that's like my brother, like my best friend in the world.
So how did it feel like having this almost, I don't want to say privileged, but privileged lifestyle, and then having friends that had all of these different experiences?
Mm-hmm.
Did you know, sometimes they say like there's survivor's guilt, or like mm-hmm. there's this like feeling like, gosh, I wish I could help them more.
Right.
Or, you know, how did that feel?
Well, you know, I speak about that a lot on the album. Mm-hmm. I think as far as being, you know, privileged, I think for me that was more so having more than one parent. Mm-hmm. For me, that was the biggest key. You know, my privilege came from having more than one parent. So we may have had the same amount of money, we may have had the same whatever, we may have was, you know, me and A was going half on a hero while we passed by the heroes. Like, we were splitting a hero in half when we were 13, 14. Like, those are what I'm speaking about. So we had the same money, but, you know, I may have had more parents than my other friends, you know, and for me, that was a huge privilege. And I speak about it on the album as far as somewhat feeling guilty at certain times or whatever. But, yeah, for me growing up, I just tried to, whatever it was that I knew outside of them, I tried to bring to the circle and vice versa. And it just, it turned us into what we became. You know, it really turned us into what we became, for better or worse. Some people say we doing all right. Some people still, you know, look at some of us a certain way, but we're all here and we made it to see past certain ages and we defied the odds. A lot of my friends, I have a lot of friends who sadly didn't, but for the most part, I got a lot of friends who we defied the odds, you know?
So you not only impart wisdom in your music, but in your everyday life.
I try to. I hope so. Because, you know, good things try to balance out.
Exactly, exactly. So. Well, we want to hear some more music.
Yeah.
All right. So what are you going to play for us next?
Not sure. Prince, whatever Prince wants, because it's okay, a freestyle it's, set.
Okay.
Freestyle set.
Whatever
freestyle
you had
set.
On the setup,
okay.
That was coming up after that as we right. freestyle the yeah, set okay. for Brooklyn. And shout out to all the people here, too.
Yes.
Shout out to everybody in here.
Let's give it up.
Yeah.
This race I run. And all that's left is everything I want. Slowly losing my time. Quickly taking that from me. Seems my friends are few. Mama said,
okay, okay.
Happiness comes from
money makes us happy. Money makes us happy. Money makes us happy. They say money makes us happy. Money makes us happy. Money makes us happy. Money makes us happy. They say money makes us happy.
Money makes us happy, and happiness is everything, and everything is now, and now is more than ever, and there'll never be a moment where happiness doesn't matter. So if you could quote the prices if you're happy, then get out of show, get out of show. Learned it from right where you saw me posted at. Grew up holding on to it all, unless there's hope attached, cause me, I don't hope for much, if anything at all. They said your cue could depend on what you could bring along, so we was bringing everything that mattered to us most. It was money, and it was cars, and it was habits keeping both. It was hundreds, and it was scars, and they just happened to be close. It was hunger getting involved, so then it was back to being broke. And we just wanted a shot or two, mellow on the follow through. Promised me it would open these doors, so what did they promise you? So I just do whatever it take to run with it all, and enough to buy my way next to Jesus if I get lost. Swag.
Scared to death, yeah. By this race I've
run, and by this race that I've run. Hey,
all that's left
is everything that I want. Okay,
so use
my time. Taken back from me, it seems my friends are few.
Mama said,
yeah,
happiness comes from money.
Money makes us happy, money makes us happy. Money makes us happy, they say money makes us happy. Money makes us happy,
yeah.
Money makes us happy,
yeah.
Money makes us happy,
yeah.
Money makes us happy. And it was falling out the sky like if Dougie Fresh was performing, and we already had too much, and so we was brushing it off with some pictures in front and back drops till like 4 in the morning. All of this dapper dan is for your tap from enjoyment. I was falling on a badge and a murderer pick a name, and my name fill a blank, and I'm blanked and I drift away, and you kiss my cold cheeks, chicks crying like I was cold cheese. Would you stand up and send me your slow speech? Because money makes us happy, and happiness is everything, and everything is now, and now is more than ever, and the never be a moment where happiness doesn't matter. So you could quote the prices of you're happy, then get out of show. Yeah, race that I run. Hey, one time and all that's left is everything that I want. Okay, slowly losing my time. Quickly taking back from me, and it seems my friends are few. Mama said to prepare, prepare, because happiness comes with money makes us happy. Money makes us happy. Money makes us happy. They say money makes us happy. Money makes us happy. Money makes us happy. Money makes us happy. They say money makes us happy. Hey, keep it going. Yeah. Yeah. Keep it going, Sean.
Keep that. Yeah. And it was falling out the sky like if Dougie Fresh was performing, and we already had too much, and so we was brushing it off with some pictures in front of backdrops till like 4 in the morning. All of this dapper dan is for your dapper enjoyment. It's falling on a badge and a murderer pick a name, and my name fill a blank, and I'm blanked and I drift away, and you kiss my cold cheeks, chicks crying like I was cold cheese. Would you stand up and send me a slow speech? Because money makes us happy, and happiness is everything, and everything is now, and now is more than ever, and there'll never be a moment where happiness doesn't matter. So you could quote the prices if you're happy, then get out of show.
Appreciate it. That's another one of my favorite
Cuts on
the album.
Everyone is your favorite.
Everyone's my favorite.
And you know what? That's how it should be. Decision. When you're buying music, that's how it should be as a fan.
It should be a complete story.
Yeah, it should be. You should be like, that's my favorite. Next one. That's my favorite. No, that's my favorite. You know what I mean? Like,
so, I mean, I love the music on it. That's the one that Bilal's on, right?
Yes, Bilal and Black Thought.
And Black Thought. Yeah. So, I mean, you had some, like, Black Thought, Bilal, Jadakiss.
Yeah.
I mean, you've had some, like, really great, you know, features as well. So, you know, talk about your relationships in the whole business.
Yeah. Oh, man, well, you know, relationships are everything in this. And what happens is the further you get along, the more relationships you make and the more, you know, you build as far as your brand, as far as your talent, word traveling and all that type of stuff. And what happens is the guys and girls that you grow up listening to become your friends, become your peers, become people that you rub shoulders with at events. And, you know, you go from memorizing every Jadakiss verse on a Clue tape to being at events with them and, you know, taking flicks and switching numbers. And then that turns into hanging out and bugging out in the studio, and that turns into music getting made. So, you know, it becomes all these ideas where when you're growing up, wish I could, you know, work with Jada, work with this one, work with that one. And then it becomes something because of what you did. These guys come up to you and show love and are like, yo, you get busy. I got you. Let's get it. And that goes for so many artists that I've had the pleasure to work with, you know, and it's not something I take lightly. It's something that I'm able to hang my hat on. You know, I'm able to really sit there and say, wow, like, I've been able to accomplish a lot in this because of the fans, because of the support that they've shown, and, you know, the response, the attention, and all those different things that trickle out to these artists and these relationships, and because of the work that I put in and what I've been blessed to be able to do.
What was your first feature where you was like, oh my gosh?
Oh, man, my first feature. Definitely early stuff with Talib. Jill Scott.
Yeah.
Jill Scott was the wild one. That was like, whoa, we did that? Like, that was, you know what I mean?
Like
I had a bunch of features, you know, before that, but, you know, building with Jill, and now that's my homie. Like, shout to Jilly. That's my homie. But even being able to say that, you know, but building with her and you know, yeah, let's kick it. Yo, let's make some music. Word, okay. I got some music right now. You want to make it up? So, you know, being able to do that, you know, John Legend, Raheem Devon, you know, it's a lot of different people. But okay. That meant a lot.
Well, one of the things I've noticed in my dealings with you is you have an incredible business sense and professionalism.
Thank you.
So, you're welcome. So, do you have advisors, or is that all you, or like? You know?
Oh, it's me. I do have certain people around me. You know, I've got a business partner by the name of Melanie Clark. I've got a business partner by the name of Chandra Sims. So, it's a lot of different people who help out. But a lot of it is me, not because I'm running around and trying to do the most, and I could do it on my own. Nah, I don't think anyone could do anything on their own. It's just for me. For one, I like the vision that I have to be executed a certain way, and I bring people on board, like the people that I named, who see the vision and they have similar 2020 and they get involved the same way. And you know, a lot of it is me being as inspired behind the scenes as I am in front of the camera. As much as I love the Michael Jackson aesthetic, I love the Quincy Jones aesthetic of being behind the scenes and really putting something together and helping other people ignite and kickstart their thing. And you know, that means a lot to me. I have a lot of ideas. Some of them make sense for me and some of them make sense for others. So if I'm able to implement those creative ideas in any way possible, whether it's for me or working with Prince or working with Sean or working with whoever, as long as the creativity is out, I'm good, you know?
I'm gonna talk more about the business aspect in a minute, but I wanna hear some music.
So. Let's do some music.
All right. Prince, let us know what's going on. I'm not gonna ask you anymore.
Jello Beats, holla at me. Hey.
I got a very special supporter in the house by the name of Super Cool Asia. This is her favorite song. Hey! Yeah. Yeah.
Check this out.
Yeah.
Check
Brooklyn, what up?
Check this out.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen,
do it like this. First generation rich. Hey. Hey. Hopefully living in a W like I'm here on business. Cause for the win, I'm seeing everyone in here with visions. But then again, I'm seeing everyone in here with visions. They too vivid, so I'm here, so no one here is living. The way that I ease up and dig a route, how we up and get them down. Gotta lean witnesses, cause my sneakers be sticking now. Why leave them to pick me out? And it before it starts, it's ripping the floor apart and then we be out. Call it inheritance part two, inherited off stoops. Got a ball for them to see what the rest of the heart do. I'm leaving scenes without a speaker left. No one here to speak of breath, my girl be a Vivica, back right, squeezing left. I mean, we ain't living enough. Flashlights, we be next. D's running up and down my ab like a CVS. Promise all I want is to be promised. This is worth a couple rags, duffel bags. Ain't no reason we ain't working. Couple racks, duffel back. Shorty be it from the surface, telling me she up for that, and hopefully it be a Birkin app. Now she praying murder deals, turn to murder hills. Pray before we spray, hope it work for real. Call it up, yeah. First generation rich, hands digging in his bag, trying to make it stick. FGR, first generation rich. I'll be the first and the last if I can stay with this. FGR, we all try and get it. We all try and get it. We all try and get it. Like, really, who we kidding? We all try and get it. We all try and get it. Like, hit the floor with it and call it FGR. We all try and get it. We all try and get it.
try and get it.
We all try and get it. Like we really get it. We all try and get it. We all try and get it. Like hit the yell with it and call it FGR.
As much as I wanted to be Theo, my day ones was more JJ. And I'm from out of Brooklyn like I'm Dwayne Wayne, like Theo. But my focus became about payday. So we on the same page, reading the same page. I'm trying to change the page, and she trying to change the line. Like, baby, if they got a surveillance, then I should be at a tent and let them see a bad bra before I squeeze at the lens. Lover, black glover, bra big, waist small. Draw attention and get the drawing away, stall. May y'all be in your best grace or be by the next safe while we screaming checkmate, checkmate, and checksmate. Need ID, so cash us. Swear that I don't mean no harm or close caskets, but this is integrity. It's been at a level 3. Now I'm trying to leave and love them down respectfully. Respect what the money is. I'm trying to detail what the money was and hold the keys to where the money lives. Yeah, pillow talk into a pillow. Know it needs to happen, but none of it probably will. Oh, FGR.
First generation rich, hands digging in this bag, trying to make it stick. FGR, first generation rich, I'll be the first and the last if I can stay with this. FGR, we all try and get it, we all try and get it, we all try and get it. Like really, who we kidding? We all try and get it, we all try and get it. Like hit the floor with it and call it FGR. We all try and get it, we all try and get it, we all try and get it. Like really, who we kidding? We all try and get it. We y'all try and get it, like hit the floor with it,
and call it FGR.
First generation rich.
Yeah.
And it's okay if money makes us happy.
Exactly. Right? See how it all tied together.
I see it. And speaking of that, mm-hmm. you know, first generation rich, if people don't know, that's your label.
Yes.
And, you know, we were just talking about your business sense.
Right.
And I see you doing some licensing things. Over the course of your career, you've had
Absolutely.
Licensing deals with HBO and ESPN.
Yeah.
And restaurants and yeah. video games.
Couple
so talk about that a little bit.
Lights stay on. No, lights stay on.
We always want the lights to stay on.
Yeah,
but, like,
yeah.
what are some of your upcoming business goals? Like, what?
Goals, let me see. Well, to continue to do what I'm doing, like all the things that we just mentioned, and also just to put the music out there as much as possible and infiltrate as many different worlds, you know, to be able to hear Skyzoo, who's a lyrical artist and whatever you want to call it, on a Buffalo Wild Wings commercial, you know, or an EA Sports game or a 2K game or, you know, ESPN baseball playoffs. So whatever the different things that I've been able to do, HBO Entourage, you know, for me, that's the checkmate right there, you know, because allegedly the guys who get those spots and you know, whoever sits at those tables are conforming to the norm, you know. And for me, being able to make the music that I want to make and stand the way I want to stand and stand tall at the same time, to still be able to sit at those tables, that's what it all comes down.
To get it and still have your integrity.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. I was going to ask you that, are you planning on putting out any artists of your own on your label?
Absolutely. For me, I feel like an artist deserves the time and attention that they foresee for themselves in their career. You know, to be an artist sitting on a back burner is the worst feeling in the world. And I want to be able to dedicate as much as I can to said artist, whoever said artist is. So I have certain people that I work with for sure. There's an artist by the name of K. Cola who's all over my album. She's somebody who I work with real heavy. A couple other people who I'm looking at, but I want to be able to devote as much time to them as possible while they're able to do their thing on their own and walk their own road and their own path. But, you know, I definitely want to work with other artists moving forward. I'm also very picky. I'm also very picky as far as, you know, what I like, regardless of anybody else is really into it a lot or not. I can see the vision and say, okay, the way it is now may be a harder pill to swallow, but I know how to finesse that. I think I know how to finesse that and work that out to where it becomes acceptable to everyone who's already a fan of me, who's a supporter of mine and things of that nature. So I'm picky at the same time, but I'm the thing about it is I'm still a fan. You know, I think anyone who's creative, whether it's music, you know, film, fashion, art, anyone who's in the arts and creative, you have to remain a fan first. The minute that you're no longer a fan is the minute that you lose your ground because you don't know what's out there. So if I don't listen to anything, if I'm not a fan and I don't listen to nobody, I don't know what's going on. These kids could be out here cooking, getting busy, and I'm chilling, you know, slowly working on the next album, and I'm not aware that, you know, Ace Clark got a mixtape, and this guy, I got to be aware, you know? So I got to know these kids is cooking so I can be in the kitchen too, you know? So I got to be a fan first.
Got it. Well, we're going to have you in the kitchen right now.
Yeah.
I think you got one more song.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. Two more songs. You got two more songs.
Let's go for it.
So let's go for it right now. And I don't know what we're going to hear, but let's
do the moments. Let's do the moments.
The moments.
Yeah. Right. The moments that matter.
The moments that matter.
That's the full title.
Yes.
That was the.
Okay.
In the band lingo. But,
cool.
Yeah.
The moments. All right. Let's hear it.
Up for the moments, so for the moment you know. First generation bitch, go like this. Moments we all waited for, dreaming down on the first, we all paying for more to be expected and more to get you acquainted on. We all in for the winner till the parade is gone. We gone and the drivers with the roof peeled, the AC on, providing how the truth feels. Cold, chilly, chill like I didn't mean to be, cause all of this here is really about the scenery. The sightseeing's like window shopping, you might see it and proceed to believe it. You bust a move, a move might be it, like the intro got it, might be it and proceed to believe it. It takes you to be you, it takes us to be us, and we the same cloth knotted up together forever. To rearrange was not in the design or the ties that bind us. We saw it and got on it, no blinders, you see it now. Wanted it as much as we wanted to breathe, top down with a beautiful scene. We saw it for the taking and wanted a piece. We saw it for the taking and made them believe. Know that moments won't change, but the moments that matter the most to us. Hey, matter the most to us. And all of this is carpe diem, double parking the BM. If the legacy is right, then we stand in mausoleums. But for now, know the moment is here and now and gone forever. Envisioning what the song get us, feeling like I'm money making rich, in the store like I'm broke, baby. Forgetting all that I got on, ain't my robes crazy? I'm in this hair looking like I sell dope, baby. To these women, I sell hope, baby. See, I swear I'm just my daddy all over again. The only one on the block, so now we all like him. Tell him money, I want the love. Baby, I want the love for all the right reasons that may just be from above. I came up where you see the paper and fall in love, and the only way you got your Mercedes was off of drugs. They put in front and center, so I saw around the corner, but the same one was parked around the corner. Explains why we wanted it as much as we wanted to breathe. Top down with a beautiful scene. Saw it for the taking and wanted a piece. We saw it for the taking and made them believe. Oh, that moment won't change. It's the moments that matter the most to us. Know that moments won't change. The moments that matter the most to us. Top down with a beautiful scene. Saw it for the taking and wanted a piece. We saw it for the taking and made them believe. We wanted it as much as we wanted to breathe. Top down with a beautiful scene. We saw it for the taking and wanted a piece. We saw it for the taking and made them believe. Wanted it as much as we wanted to breathe.
All right, so I feel crazy because there's so much more that I wanted to talk to you about.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Like, I hear you're a big Wire fan.
Absolutely.
That A Love Supreme is your favorite album?
Love Supreme, absolutely.
Like, all these different things, so yeah. We have to find an excuse to get you back here.
Let's do it. To the producers and everybody behind the scenes, you see it, yeah, the people want it.
But I so appreciate you coming through.
Thank you.
You're going to give us one more song later.
Yes.
In a minute,
yeah.
Like in a little bit.
Absolutely.
But, you know, yeah, let us know, like, what's coming up next for you. Like, what's on the horizon?
Oh, man, so the horizon, touring overseas, Africa's first up, South Africa. UK, a full Europe run, Australia, all that stuff within the next like 3 to 4 months. New music, but I'm marinating. You know, I like to take a little time because with my music, I write about my life and things that really happen and go on. So I gotta live a little bit. I can't put out an album today and then go start another album tomorrow. You know, I gotta live in between so that I have things to speak on, write about, and emotions and events and feelings that people can relate to. Because they can say, I'm going through the same thing, you know? So new music soon, not tomorrow, but soon. And I'm also doing a lot of other writing. You know, I do a lot of songwriting and ghostwriting for people and things of that nature. Yeah, I do a little bit of that. Sports journalism writing. I'm a huge basketball fan, so now I'm in that world as well, and I'm doing a lot of sports journalism stuff. And I've actually decided, I said, well, how can I tell stories beyond the beat being on, but being able to be as creative and as, you know, whatever it is that I feel like doing at the moment. And I took screenwriting classes a while ago, and I am writing a television series that I'm fully penning myself. Pilot episode done, halfway through the first season, writing on my own, fully scripted hour-long drama series for TV that I'm in the process of shooting a pilot and pitching and castings and auditions.
BRIC TV?
Absolutely. Let's go. Well, this show is raw. I don't know if you know, this is raw. I don't know how raw BRIC can go. This is raw.
All right. Well, we'll talk about that in
behind the scenes.
Behind the scenes.
You pull the checkbook out. Nah.
Okay. We're nonprofit. All right. Well, thanks for coming.
Absolutely. And I'm honored to be here with you guys. It's been a pleasure indeed.
Thank you. All right, well, it's about that time for us to break out. I'm Ro Johnson, and I hope you've enjoyed spending this time in our studio. Massive gratitude to Skyzoo and his crew for treating us to an hour of the vibrant lyricism and instrumentality he's known for. And be sure to check out more at skyzoothewriter.com. He's also on Facebook, SoundCloud, Twitter, and all of that. So go check him out, support his music, and be sure to go to youtube.com/BRICTV to check out this and past episodes of B-Side. Be sure to also tune in every Thursday, next Thursday included, and hear the best music our borough has to offer. Until then, be good, Brooklyn. Good night.
Record called Luxury. Designer sweats off designer plugs. My fan base pedal krills or designer love. Money hand over fist like a Steiner glove. Drop Jeep box seats, what I remind you of. Aura of the city, everything that I came for. And to carry on, I carry on like a wave board. Hand and work to whoever like if my aim gone. Fly murder forever like it's your name, Lord. Devil wear Prada, Hitler wear Hermes. Hobby and Celine, with your queen going burlesque. Either that or supreme, I'm supreme, lead a deity. Crowned off a point, how I weave where the needle be. And it's leaving legendary if it come to me. Rep means everything, mine means luxury. And we try and turn bread like Marlowe. Tucking Marlowe with a Parlow arms full. Hey, if I don't make it, bet the fam will. Now watch the city fall in love with us. Hey, Clyde Frazier with the hand skills. Ha, the rings, baby, double up. Yeah, wore the same Balmain's out south for a week straight, frying like we ain't rich. Hey, baddest chick you ever seen in your life, pulling bottles all night like she want a chip. Hey, you know we here for the luxury. Yeah, you know we here for the luxury. Yeah,
until we filthy with that bankroll. You know we here for the luxury.
Yeah, when it lasts forever, baby. Hey, swear to God, it's like we want it ready. Word to counting everything and we done drunk already. The only thing that they can say is that they wasn't ready. Real, salute to how we was brought up. Fly guy etiquette turned us into marauders. High throw etiquette round, know what they taught us. And short chains and ball means how God want us. Ha! Luxury, see where that'll get you. With a CC or more, try and be like Ken Civil. Prank game silly, so my Nike tag gorgeous. Cash but friendly, writing for the Forbes. It's that, yeah, Earl of Pearl when I'm at it, B. So who you love is being me, all flattery, right?
flattered to be what they never was. First to the money, everything is FGR, and I do believe it though. If I don't make it, bet the fam will. And watch the city fall in love with us. Hey, Clyde Frazier with the hand skills. Double rings, baby, double up. Yeah, water same bound means outside for a week straight, frontin' like we ain't rich. Baddest chick you ever seen in your life, pouring bottles all night like she wanna chip. You know we here for the luxury, yeah. You know we here for the luxury, yeah. Until we filthy with that bankroll.
You know we here for the luxury.
Crowns all around, we about to win. Luxury talk, yeah, everybody want in. All day once, with it till it ends. Counting up together, same as it been. Crowns all around, we about to win. Luxury talk, yeah, everybody want in. All day once, with it till it ends. Counting up together, same as it been. You know what we about, right? I'm for the same bound man's outside. 4 weeks straight, frontin' like we ain't rich. Ha!
Baddest chick
you ever seen in your life, pulling bottles all night like she wanna chip. Hey,
you know we here for the luxury.
Yeah, you know we here for the luxury. Yeah, until we filthy with that bankroll. You know we here for the luxury. Balmain's outside for a week straight, frontin' like we ain't rich. Baddest chick you ever seen in your life, pullin' bottles all night like she want a chip. You know we here for the luxury. You know we here for the luxury. Until we filthy with that bankroll. You know we here for the luxury.